Having a miscarriage is a sad thing. It's something that's very difficult to talk about. Medically, we also term it as abortion. We use it intermittently. So sometimes you come to the hospital and the doctor might say that, have you had an abortion before? He doesn't mean if you've killed or you've taken a baby out before. Sometimes it's just a miscarriage. We just kind of use the words interchangeably. In this video, we are going to talk about some of the causes of miscarriages, stroke abortions. If you want to find out more, please continue watching this video. This is Time with Dr. Adams. Time with Dr. Adams. Hi there. Welcome to another episode of Time with Dr. Adams. In this episode, we are going to talk about what miscarriage stroke abortion is. Depending on the country you find yourself, it can be pregnancy that is up to 20 weeks or 24 weeks. In Ghana, it is up to 28 weeks. That is what we term as miscarriage or abortion. I want to tell you out there, if you are watching this video, if you've ever had a miscarriage or abortion, sometimes it's just not your fault. We have something we call spontaneous abortion. It just happens. And medically, we will not be able to find what really caused it. But sometimes there are specific causes, and that is what we are going to talk about. So remember, number one is what we call spontaneous abortion or miscarriage. It just happened. And medically, we cannot tell what caused it. We also have causes such as drugs. There are some women who take some medications they are not supposed to take. That is why we always advocate that stop going to ANC immediately when you find out that you are pregnant, because some medications over the counter that you buy can cause abortion, can make you lose your baby even when you did not want to. Taking alcohol, smoking can also cause miscarriage or abortion. It doesn't mean if today you took you smoked one one stick of cigarette, you are going to get an abortion or you're going to miscarry today. No, it has to happen over a period of time, and it depends on the number of times you smoke. Same as alcohol, it depends on the amount of alcohol in there, the ethanol. It also depends on how many bottles you take. So usually you can see on the pack or on the bottles that pregnant women are not supposed to take it. Other reasons are chromosomal abnormalities. I do not want to bore you, but in this case, it just means that you and your partner, your genes or your chromosomes did not match, and it wasn't up to the number that is supposed to be. It's supposed to be 46. So God being so wonderful, the body just rejects that baby. It doesn't mean both of you have done anything bad. It just happened that the number of chromosomes that it was supposed to pick up or supposed to produce was more or even less. Then it just brings it out. And then sometimes the mothers have some chronic illness such as diabetes, hypertension, obesity, which can cause miscarriage or abortion. And then we also have infections. I want to use the word common infections, like malaria. Severe malaria can make you miscarry or get an abortion. Also, urinary tract infection, quote unquote, is a simple infection, but then yes, it can make you get an abortion or miscarry. So anytime you feel a burning sensation when you urinate, especially when you are pregnant, or lower abdominal pain, please report to your doctor. And then we have other infections such as tuberculosis, HIV, cytomegaly. I do not want to bore you, but generally infection as a whole can cause you to miscarry or have an abortion. Other causes such as if your partner, you and your partner are old, elderly parents, sometimes when you take seed, you can have complications along the way. Extreme exercise or doing something so tedious can also cause you to miscarry. In all this, some of these causes can be picked up if you go to ANC. I cannot overemphasize that if you are pregnant, immediately you find out that you are pregnant, please go to your nearest hospital to see a doctor or a midwife. Let them guide you through. If there's any questions you want to ask, you ask them. If there's anything you are feeling, you ask them. If there's any medications you are on, you have any pre-existing conditions, you let them know so that they guide you through. They know what is best to do for you. I cannot overemphasize again that everyone's condition is different. The fact that your neighbor has diabetes and was able to give birth to 3 children does not mean you having diabetes will also go through the same path as your neighbor did. Yours might be different because everyone's body is different. But the best thing to do is always go to the hospital. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section below. Contributions, if you want to share your miscarriage, what caused your abortion or miscarriage, and just know that sometimes it's just not your fault. Spontaneous abortion also happens. This was Time with Dr. Adams. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe and see you in another video. And remember, be kind to each other and still be a smoke. Time with Dr. Adams.